spin me around. People get used to and bookmark sites like VidMe, VID.me, VidMe. Bookmark that site, folks, because YouTube may soon go completely vanilla on you.
It's Sunday night, and the National Security Advisor, General McMaster, has come out and said that the crisis with North Korea is now coming to a head since the official ceasefire in 1953 on July 27th. North Korea has never backed down before, firing missiles at Japan, testing nuclear weapons. But it appeared on the 15th that they had backed down. But then, as soon as the 16th rolled around, they tested an ICBM aimed at Japan, but it blew up on the launch pad. We covered that yesterday. The reason this is so important is North Korea is threatening to nuke its neighbors. North Korea is threatening to attack Japan, South Korea. And China, after negotiations with President Trump, said, we're going to come in and threaten to basically militarily attack them if they launch a provocation. So as soon as the press reported, as we did, that North Korea had finally blinked, it appears in a face-saving activity, his generals blew up a missile, probably one of those dummies they admit was fake, that was in the parade 2 days ago, on the launch pad. But regardless, why is it still coming to a head? We have to ask General McMaster that, and he breaks down the reasons. It's on Infowars.com. It's on CNN, General McMaster, all options on the table for North Korea. McMaster, North Korea coming to a head. That's this Sunday, April 16th, 2017. And you've got the situation in Syria. You've got all these other situations where most analysts agree this is the most dangerous time in modern history. I'm drawing attention to this so there's public attention so we can have a debate about it to avert war. But McMaster says they're polishing all options for military strikes on North Korea. That wouldn't be an offensive strike, but I'm not, by the way, calling for it. God, who would call for that? But the problem is, under common law or international law, North Korea is aiming missiles at Japan and South Korea, testing them, threatening to preemptively nuke people first. So if someone's got a gun pointed at you saying, I'm going to pull the trigger, any minute, I'm going to kill you, then do you have a right to then stand up against them and go after them? So tomorrow, we're going to have Paul Watson in studio from London. Mike Cernovich is going to stay an extra day. He's going to be in studio with us. And so much more tomorrow, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Central. That said, if they can try to shut us down and sell the idea that we're fake news and take jokes we say and say it's serious, they can shut you down. And this is really about shutting the people down on social networks, just on their own websites, whatever. That's what this whole system is about, is shutting you up. That's why they see us as the number one enemies. That's why it's so important to spread those links, to defeat all their censors, to defeat their systems, because we're starting to win.
Exactly. Again, the whole YouTube thing is not a left-right issue. It's driven by, they want to encourage people not to say anything controversial. So it doesn't matter if you're from the left, from the right. If you become discouraged from saying something controversial because you know that video will be banned, it will be demonetized, even if you've got a huge Patreon base of supporters donating to you, you're still going to be discouraged from making that controversial video, from being edgy, God forbid. And that's what YouTube's trying to do. They're trying to become the new Netflix. They're trying to sanitize everything.
That's right. Absolutely. A control paradigm they keep you in.
There's no
Look,
map.
Look, Paul, I have a map.
There's no map. I'm outside.
Where's the map? We're in Austin, Texas, living the dream, having a good time. Tomorrow we'll be doing a show tomorrow from like noon to one, something like that?
It's 1 to 2, yeah.
1 to 2, there you go. 1 to 2 Central Time. I just found out from a source, breaking news, I was going to break this tomorrow. InfoWars is now being delisted and de-indexed from Google. They actually sent an all-points bulletin to all contractors to rate every InfoWars link as low quality. So this will destroy the SEO value. That way when people Google Alex Jones, that's another way that they can try to control the narrative. So share the InfoWar links, because Google is trying to get InfoWars removed from its search engine.
It's funny you say that. They launched their main attack today, and I can't even get into it, but it's total upside down reality. Everything they say is the opposite.
Right, exactly. So I actually, it's funny you mentioned it was today, because that's when I got the message today. They're saying rank any article, no matter how true it is, at InfoWars.
Your co-host, Paul Watson.
That's right. 11 a.m.
So good Tune stuff. In. We got Buckley and everybody else over there.
Yeah, the whole squad.
All another evil people. How's it going, brothers?
I just want to let you know that I'm here to basically get you to think.